Hello, everyone. Just a word about counter manipulation. That seemed to have been going around for a little bit in YouTube videos, and I do believe Activism of Care was the one who coined the term counter manipulation, and he recommends it a lot. It's a good idea. It really is. Sasha Sloan also has different methods of counter manipulating. There seemed to be some controversy about it at the time, and I'm not really sure why. Because Grey Rock, for example, is counter manipulation, right? And then it's just a way to protect yourself. Sam Vaknin also talks about counter manipulation. He just doesn't call it that. He gives suggestions on mirroring your narcissist, infusing them with supply to get what you want or need from them. He even suggests at some point, if they rage at you, you rage back to them. That would be counter manipulation or mirroring, right? So that's all that is. Now, I have a few of my own that I use, especially with my mother. Now, keep in mind, counter manipulation works on your garden variety narcissist, okay? It's like they're colorblind. Once you catch on to them and you give them what they need, you figure out what that is, and that's usually, I'll just use my mother as an example, was listening to her negativity and empathizing with her, okay? So I'll go into that a little more, but once you figure out what your narcissist needs, most of them need to be right. Some of them just want to bitch and complain and drain your energy. That's for sure. Others are passive aggressive. So once you understand all these different manipulations that the narc is pulling on you, you can preempt them, and it's as if they're colorblind. They don't see what you're doing. Just like when the narcissist was manipulating you and you didn't see what they were doing. So I use my mother as an example. When my kids were little, long time ago, I used them a lot as an excuse to get off the phone. So I gave myself a strict time limit with her because she was so incredibly negative. Oh my God. 15 or 20 minutes was all I could handle. And so I would not let it go beyond that point. I even set a timer just so I wouldn't get caught up in the conversation and be too nice to hang up or anything like that. And I would just make an excuse. Oh, somebody's at the door. Sorry, I got to go run an errand. I have to start dinner. Oh, wait a minute. One of the kids needs me. Got to go now. Call you later. Bye. Right? So time limits work really well with narcissists. They're none the wiser. Just make an excuse. And also, what worked with my mother was listening. There was really nothing I could contribute to the conversation when she was going on and on and on, very, very negative. And I would just listen. Sometimes I would just put down the phone. Yeah. She didn't even know. Like if I had to go get something for a few minutes, I would just put down the phone, go get it, come back. She's still talking. Yeah. Like that. So what I would do is I would just listen. If she was in that kind of a mood, which was very frequently, then I would empathize. I was just going to say overemphasize, but that too, my empathy. I would pour it on thick. So I would listen, and then just to let her know that I was listening, I would say, "Oh, that's awful. Oh, that's too bad. Oh, I know how that feels. Oh." And it worked. She actually, at one point, before she got off the phone with me, said, "For some reason, I feel better. I don't know what it is, but I feel so much better." And that's how I would handle my mother. Was the empathy real? No, not really. Because she would talk about things that had nothing to do with me, other people, situations, her husband. I had no idea most of the time who she was talking about, But the negativity was there. It was awful, awful, awful. And so I would just fake empathy, lots of it. I would just pour it on. So one of the last favorite tactics of mine is of counter manipulation. When the narcissist needs to be right, they always need to be right, right? So you're typically going to have a one-sided relationship, a one-sided conversation. There is no discussion. There is no agree to disagree, right? We can all agree on that with a narcissist. So with my narcissist, to get him off my back when we were in the house living together, and he needed to be right, he would just out of the blue, sideswipe me with, you do this all the time and you do that all the time, and shame on you was the intent behind it, right? And so I would say, well, yeah, I am that some of the time. You're right. And boom, the bubble would burst. He didn't know what to say. I just agreed with him. No, I'm not those things all of the time, but I am those things some of the time. And I can't think of an example right off the top of my head. Let's see. You're so lazy. We'll just use that one. All of the time. If you're with a narcissist or a personality disorder or cluster B, they're going to use black and white thinking, all or nothing. So you're going to hear things like all of the time, or you don't do it any of the time. Right? Well, that's not possible. We live in a dichotomous world, right? But there is a gray area, and you can't be all of these things all of the time, or none of these things none of the time, right? So yeah, if he would say, "You're so lazy," I would say, "Yeah, sometimes I can be really lazy," and he would just go psh, and walk out of the room. The face with the like he just sucked on a lemon. Yeah, that's a great way to burst their bubble. Just agree. But agree in a way that's normal, healthy, not all or nothing. Yeah, I do that some of the times. Yeah, sure. Everybody does, right? Your narcissist will hate that. So anyway, I hope that made sense. And I really love the term counter manipulation. In my circumstance right now, the difference between your garden variety narcissist and, let's say, for example, my mother and my narcissist now is very, very different. Counter manipulation does not work on him. Those narcissists that are high on the spectrum with psychopathic traits, like mine is, believe me, any thing I say or do, any emotion I have, he immediately takes that as a manipulation. He's assuming I'm manipulating him all of the time. So counter manipulation doesn't really work at this point in time. It used to work just for the little things when he needed to be right, and I'd say, "Sure, you're right. Do you feel better now?" If you need to be right, go ahead and be right. I don't care. Right? So anyway, depending on where the narcissist is on the spectrum, especially like I said, if they're lower on the spectrum, they're colorblind. They don't see what you're doing, and it's a way to protect yourself. You're not fooling them per se, you're protecting yourself, and you're cutting the interaction short. You're not letting them go on and on and drain you of your energy. And so it's sort of a win-win. They get what they need, right? The mirroring, and for example, my mother, the overemphasis on empathy, right? And I get off the phone quickly. Other narcissists, it just depends. But what I really caution against, though, because of my particular narcissist, if you know that yours is a psychopath or one of the deadly tetrad, do not try counter manipulation. They're already 10 steps ahead of you, so they'll be using it against you. In my case, it's Not advised whatsoever, and other people's cases too, where they know they're dealing with a psychopath or a deadly tetrad, dark triad, whatever you want to call it. These people can be dangerous, and they live for manipulation. And everything you do or say, it's almost like they can see right through you. So unless you're like them, which is not possible if you're an empathetic person with a conscience, you cannot think like them. You just cannot. So it's not recommended for those sorts. If you think you can outsmart them, you cannot. Your brain isn't even the same as theirs. They're predators, plain and simple. They've been doing this their whole lives. So I thought that was kind of fun to think about, because I was trying to recall times when I used counter manipulation and it worked. Those times that I used it, and maybe that helps someone today. Peace out.